Hello and thank you once again for tuning in to this video. I'm going to share with you my Caesar salad home edition. Well, Parmesan cheese is a little bit expensive, but you deserve to treat yourself and your loved ones once in a while with good food. Romano and Asiago cheeses are cheaper alternatives for Parmesan cheese. And of course, you will also save a little bit if you make your own Caesar salad at home. And why not invite your friends and relatives during special occasions and serve them with your heaven-sent Caesar salad? For sure, it is very well highly appreciated. And so I have here the list of the items I need for my Caesar salad and also for the dressing ingredients and also the sour cream recipe as alternative to creme fraiche or buttermilk. And so I'll be making first the dressing, and by combining all the ingredients in this bowl, I'll start with the 3 to 4 pieces anchovies fillet. If you don't like anchovies, then you can use Worcestershire sauce. Then the raw egg, which is an alternative for the mayonnaise, but for the warmer countries I don't recommend using raw eggs. Then the olive oil, and then here comes the Dijon mustard, and the finely shredded Parmesan, which is very important. And then the 2 tablespoons of lemon juice freshly squeezed. For info, not all are using Parmesan in the dressing, but for me it's a real Caesar salad dressing without it. And so I'm throwing in some salt and pepper, but not necessarily because Parmesan and anchovies are already salty. And so I add in my minced garlic. It's also an important part in the dressing. And I'll mix them with my handy or stick mixer. You can use the blender if you like, but I don't like to wash the heavy blender afterwards. So that is for my own convenience. And for info, the egg yolk and the Dijon mustard are good emulsifiers. That's why I'm combining all the ingredients, including the oil in the bowl, and just stir them all the way. And of course, I forgot the creme fraiche, but it's not too late. I will add in there and just continue beating and stirring until the everything becomes smooth and creamy dressing. And see how this tiny handy mixer making wonder in my tiny kitchen. And I'm using this even in making smoothies sometimes. And see, in less than 5 minutes, my dressing is done. And look at that perfect dressing. It should be the texture, and you could still see the tiny particles of the Parmesan and the anchovies fillet. Of course, you can always make it finer and smoother just the way you like it. So for now, I will cover this inside the refrigerator, and I'll go proceed to preparing the remaining salad ingredients. I'm now slicing my chicken breast fillet in diagonal. I took it out from the freezer yesterday and let it slowly thaw in the fridge because I'm not reheating my chicken meat. And if you like, you can check out my separate video for my pan-fried chicken breast fillet. And so I'm gonna rinse my lettuce leaves thoroughly to remove all the nasty insects and dirts that were hiding in between those beautiful leaves. Same thing with the lemon, the cucumber, and the tomatoes. I'm gonna slicing them in small bite sizes and place them in separate bowl. Other versions of Caesar salad, they have avocado, they have pasta, they have bacon, or even shrimps. Of course, you can do your own Caesar salad, whatever you want. But mine is limited to only just cucumber, tomatoes, slice of eggs, and of course, the chicken fillet. The vital ingredient here is actually the dressing, because if your dressing is not good, then it's good for nothing salad. And well, you don't want it that way. So I just leave the sliced lettuce leaves in the strainer to allow it drain out excess water, because you don't have extra water in your plate. Of course, you can use clean towel to dry them up, or you can Clean the little slips as early as possible ahead of time so they are well drained. And now I'm cutting my parmesan flakes with my cheese hand slicer. And also my eggs are sliced, and now time to toast my garlic bread. Well, it is croutons that are widely used in almost all versions of Caesar salad, but I don't have time to make croutons for now, so that my toasted garlic bread will surely do in place of those crunchy croutons. And well, as I've said earlier, it is the dressing that matters most for the Caesar salad. Now the final moment has arrived. Time to assemble my Caesar salad in my own plate. This is only for demo purposes. I don't normally toast my salad ingredients in a big bowl. No, I don't normally do that. I just let the person do his or her own salad in her or her own plate. And then you can arrange your Caesar salad the way you like it. I'm sure in fine dining, restaurants do have their own standard presentation of their Caesar salad. And if you have leftovers, don't you worry, the dressing can stay in the fridge for up to 4 days, so you can indulge yourself with Caesar salad for many days, as long as you like. And shortly, I'm gonna satisfy my cravings for this delicious Caesar salad. And I thank you for watching. I hope you like this video, and I wish you all the best, and keep safe. God bless.